Kwaba, and welcome to the Pan-African Orthodox Christian Church of the Shrines of the Black Madonna's weekly stream broadcast. I'm Pastor Mayu Chui from the Mother Shrine here in Detroit. And on behalf of our virtual village, which includes Detroit, Atlanta, Houston, Beulah Land at Calhoun Falls, South Carolina, and Monrovia and Ganta City, Liberia, West Africa, we appreciate you joining us. And we ask that you don't forget to donate, like, comment, and share all of our online content with other like-minded souls in order to help us build a united Pan-African world community. Asante Sana, we're glad you're here.
Our goal is to be the church of the future. The 21st century mystery temple. A place where the church is a tool for human development, human growth and evolution, the recovery of Black people's humanity and dignity, and a power center for Black self-determination. We're doing it in every city that we're in, and we're gonna do it in every city we're gonna go to, in order to facilitate the consciousness raising of Black people. Our goal, simply said, is to restore our people to our original place of power and dignity in the world. Amen.
Welcome to the Shrine of the Black Madonna here in Houston, Texas. The Shrine is a best self movement committed to enlightening, empowering, and elevating Black people. We are located here in Houston, Texas, Detroit, Michigan, Atlanta, Georgia, in Calhoun Falls, South Carolina, and Liberia, West Africa, with members throughout the diaspora. During this time of crisis brought on by the global pandemic and the rapid spread of coronavirus, we continue to practice social distancing and have suspended our in-person gatherings and rely on online presence. In the midst of uncertainty and turmoil, we continue to be committed to our mission of empowering and uplifting people. Today is Father's Day. Happy Father's Day to all the fathers. We are fortunate to have a powerful word from Pastor Aswad Walker. Let us pray. Let's prepare for the prayer of invocation. Almighty One, Giver of Life, our ever-present source of help and strength, we invite your presence among us across this unified energy field as we walk together through this turbulent cycle of transition and transformation sponsored by COVID-19. Lord, grant comfort, mercy, and peace to those suffering, loss of loved ones, healing to those who are enduring sickness, breakthroughs for those who are in need of their daily sustenance, and blessings upon all who have gathered with us in this virtual village to receive a word that will encourage us to move forward in our struggle to build a Pan-African world and community with dignity, power, and righteousness. In the name of the revolutionary standard bearer, Jesus, we pray, saying Ashe and Amen.
Oh, Black Daddy.
He is my king. He is my one. Yes, he's my father.
A Black Daddy who make dreams come true or die trying. He'll do his best to keep from lying. When he promises his precious princess, she'll become a real African queen. Reassures his son that in this world he can be anything. Though he is fully aware that life cheats, and he might be the only king his baby girl meets. And the best his boy might be anywhere, anyhow, anyway, is a spitting image of his black daddy on any good day. But he is daddy, papa, a warrior when once were warriors, struggling still. For those who look up to their expectation of iron will. Searching his eyes for hope when theirs is dying. And he delivers best he can, or the black daddy will die trying. The black daddy says things like, don't judge a book by its cover. He really wants to believe this world can be just to culture and color. And he thinks that if he teaches his children to give, life will repay them by letting them live. In a world that he paints with pastel hues, before their innocent eyes are forced to behold, that everything that's glittering ain't made of gold. And truth be told, he hammers out a world of humanity, harmony, kind words, and peace before their ears are forced to hear sounds of slander increase. He is daddy, papa, a warrior when once were warriors struggling still. For those who look up to their expectation of iron will, searching his eyes for hope when theirs is dying, and he delivers best he can, or the black daddy will die trying to balance an unbalanced situation, die trying to rectify reality for a blindsided generation, die trying to preach prospect on roads of impossibility, die trying to transplant his own mental and physical agility to his sons and his daughters, to those who are not even his own. But tenting the torrid truth takes its toll, and by then they're all grown. The black daddy, holding high his legacy upon his shoulders, walks the line of rabbit-proof fences, a foot in each world of predestined stars and princes. One world demanding double dues already paid, blues already slayed. The other tilting over the margin, teetering over the brink, ostracized and polarized. But his soul is vested in their survival, in seeing ancestral dreams realized. Because he is daddy, papa, a warrior when once were warriors struggling still. For those who look up to their expectation of iron will, searching his eyes for hope when theirs is dying. He'll give them a mustard seed to move mountains if they have a mind. Deliver best he can or he will die trying.
It's me, oh Lord, and
God, our creator and sustainer, I pray for healing for all who are sick, whether physically or emotionally injured. I pray for strength for those who are weak. We pray for clarity for those who are confused. I pray for the renewal for all who are caught up in despair. Today we need an infusion of power, energy, and determination as we witness the world over countless voices that proclaim our desire of freedom, freedom from oppression. Freedom from exploitation, freedom from systematic racism. I pray that these voices resound loud as the rolling seas and the rock of the world back and rocks the world back into balance. We know that our power moves through the group that upholds and prepares us to build for the future. Bless all the fathers on this day and all those days forward. We ask this prayer in the Black Messiah Jesus' name. Ashe. Amen.
It is me. It's me, it's me, it's me, and I am standing in the need of prayer. It's me. It's me.
This is Aswad Walker, Associate Pastor of the Shrine here in Houston, Texas. And today's Father's Day message is entitled, Keep Your Head to the Sky. And we take our scripture from Psalm 68:31 that says, Princes shall come out of Egypt, and Ethiopia shall stretch forth her hands unto thee. Again, keep your head to the sky. In our present world context, where black folk are once again swinging from trees like strange fruit, six lynched in the last month alone, while law enforcement expects us to believe the lie that they were all suicides. In a world where the death of an ordinary black man could spark an extraordinary global movement, yet Rashard Brooks could be shot in the back and killed by cops just days later in arguably America's blackest city, where the cops could have let him walk home or call him an Uber or drop him at home themselves, all the things they do for white folk every single day. In a world where the killers of Breonna Taylor have still not been charged, just like the killers of Sandra Bland, Freddie Gray, Trayvon Martin, Michael Brown, Eric Garner, Philando Castile, Terrence Crutcher, Rakia Boyd, Tamir Rice, Ayanna Jones, and so many others. Individuals who stole black lives and black futures, walking around with neither care nor concern. In a world where black people are target practice, where black women are the most educated yet the most disrespected and most abused, where black men are being written out of the lives of our people by the criminal injustice system. In a world such as this, what are we to do? For Father's Day, when folks still believe the myth that there are no black fathers, even though statistics show that black fathers are just as present and often even more present in the lives of their children than any other fathers of any other race. In such a world of the upside down, what are we to do? I contend the answer can be found in the title of a 1973 Earth, Wind, and Fire song. What can we do? Keep your head to the sky. Our presiding bishop, Jeremoji Mili Kimathi, says that manhood is essentially about a people's dignity. That dignity comes from God, and that manhood is essentially about a people's dignity. It's our ability to provide, protect, care for, our ability to act and envision with agency and power. But everything about our existence in this country has been about tearing down our dignity, tearing down black manhood and those male energies of vision, protection, reason, action, assertiveness, those male energies that we all have. See, we each, men and women, possess both male energies and female energies. It's the yin and yang of creation. We need them both to be healthy and whole. We need them both to thrive and survive, both as individuals and as a people. To ignore or downplay either one is dangerous to our present and future. Celebrating Father's Day for us should be a recognition and celebration of those male energies, those manhood, those father energies that are in all of us, that we all need. These energies, I'm talking about the inner drive to be logical, to reason, to see things as they are, but to also be visionary and see what can be. Male energies like discipline, protection, direction, survival, and action and assertiveness. Attacking our manhood, attacking our dignity was and is an attack on all these energies in both our brothers and our sisters. And the colonizers used everything. Slavery, Jim Crow, convict leasing, redlining, domestic terrorism, police brutality, religion, advertising, education, you name it, it's been used to tear down black manhood, to tear down the dignity of our people. Our beloved founder and first holy patriarch, the Honorable Jeremoji Abebe Ajiman, said in his book, The Black Messiah, often we don't think of our dignity as something of great value, but take from you your dignity and you have nothing left. Take from you the right to hold your head up, to feel that you are a man, a woman, the right to think, to be. Take away that dignity and there's nothing left but a groveling animal, a slave. The scripture he used spoke and speaks to America's relationship with black people. It's Psalm 62, verse 3. How long will you set upon a man to shatter him like a leaning wall, a tottering fence? They only plan to tear him down from his dignity. The image of that Minneapolis cop with his knee in the neck of George Floyd, with his hands in his pocket, that smug look of nonchalance, that image tells you everything you need to know about America. They only plan to tear us down from our dignity. And the onlookers, seeing this murder taking place, were screaming, "Stop it! You kill him! Get your knee off his neck!" They may as well have been screaming, "How long will you set upon a man to shatter him?" Like they've set upon and beaten and belittled and degraded us for generations for standing up like men, to instill fear in us, to break us, to keep our heads hanging low. Beaten, we looked white folk in the eye, trained to lower our gaze, to hang our heads low, a symbol of submission, powerlessness, and helplessness. The war on our manhood, on our dignity, is to make us feel helpless and broken, and to hang our heads low, which is why today's scripture is so critically important, and why Marcus Garvey, the patron saint of the black nation, loved it so. That scripture, Psalm 68, verse 31, reminds us that your God-bestowed dignity gives you the right, the power, the agency to hold your head up, to reclaim your manhood and your dignity, to keep your head to the sky. It says, "Princes shall come out of Egypt, and Ethiopia shall stretch forth her hands unto thee." Now, peep this. The white enslavers read those words and took it to mean that all of Africa's children were destined to bow down and stretch out their hands in submission to white God, white people, and their non-existent white Peckerwood Messiah. White abolitionists took these words to mean the enslaved were stretching out their hands unto those kindly white people for deliverance from slavery and from our African savagery. But Marcus Mosiah Garvey, however, exercising every ounce of the manhood and dignity given to him by Almighty God, said, "Y'all better get somewhere with that bull stuff." He read those words for what they were: a call that said Africa for the Africans, a call that said, "Up, ye mighty race, accomplish what you will." For Garvey, that scripture was about reclaiming our God-given dignity, to lift our heads up, to divorce ourselves from the idea that we should be ashamed of being black, that we should be ashamed of being children of Africa. No, 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 hell no. Garvey was like, lift up your heads, lift up your gaze so that you can see what I see. For princes shall come out of Egypt, and Ethiopia shall stretch forth her hands unto thee. In other words, it's nation time. Time to set up the black man and woman's government. Time to appoint our own men and women of big affairs. Black man, black woman, black child, lift your head up. Keep your head to the sky so that we can reclaim our dignity, our manhood. It's been said, this is why George Floyd placed his daughter Gianna on his shoulders so often: to see beyond the world what the world said she was, to see herself rising above, to catch a glimpse of her unlimited potential, her God-given dignity. And that's what manhood is all about. That's what our manhood, our dignity is supposed to do. Put our people on our backs, on our shoulders, so together we can see beyond the limiting pronouncements of a world that seeks to tear us down. What George Floyd did for his daughter, we are called to do now, every single day. To do the things that allow us to reclaim our dignity, to reclaim our manhood. First, we're called to be logical and rational and tell it like it is. The Reverend Dr. Martin Luther King looked logically at how white Christians organized their religion and their society, and he called it out. He saw that colonizer Christians viewed depravity, being born in sin, as basic to the human condition. And so they accepted man-made tragedies, poverty and homelessness, hunger and equality, as unavoidable necessities for modern society, things they could live with. No. King said, y'all must be on some dumb stuff, because my divine logic says that we are God's children with God-given dignity. We have an inherent somebody-ness. So with his logic, he said we should be living in a world where we don't kill children in the name of, in Vietnam, in the name of democracy, where food doesn't go to waste while people go hungry, where religious folk don't feel comfortable sitting on the sidelines while the world goes to hell. Our manhood, our dignity demands that we tell it like it is, like the Reverend Dr. Martin Luther the King, like Malcolm X, like Fannie Lou Hamer. Second, we're called to be visionary, to see the not yet, like the artistry of Octavia Butler, like the courage of Harriet Tubman, and the prophetic teachings of the Honorable Jeremoji Abebe Ajimon that inspired the words, God gave me a song that black people forever shall sing. Freedom burns in my heart like a volcanic flame. We shall be free. My God has made no slave of me. He gave me strength for unity, to build a nation black and strong, with power to fight and right the wrongs. With God on our side and Jesus our God, our nation black shall rise again. Once again, our manhood, our dignity demands that we let our people know, whoever you are, wherever you are, in whatever organization, church, temple, mosque you belong to, you can stay there and still join our movement to build a better tomorrow today, a kingdom of God here on earth. And lastly, we are called to be assertive, to take actions that provide protection and ensure our survival. Namely, we must celebrate black manhood every chance we get. Black men of greatness and great renown, celebrate them, lift them up. Malcolm X, Martin Luther King, Medgar, Paul Robeson, Steve Biko, Charles Drew, Louis Latterman, so many others. But celebrate also those ordinary everyday brothers, our fathers, uncles, teachers, coaches, who worked jobs that they were overqualified for, paid far less than what they deserved, caught hell, but they endured to pay the bills, to put food on the table, provide roofs over our heads, to mentor us and encourage us. Our presiding bishop, Jeremoji Menele Kimathi, says that if we value something, we must celebrate it in order to keep it and hold on to it. So for black survival, we must celebrate black men and black manhood and those men in our lives who made a difference, and those sisters who exhibited that male energy. And moreover, we must assertively invest in programs that make a way for our economic freedom, like Beulah Land and the Buy Black Marketplace. We must also enlighten ourselves and our children via our African history classes, black theology classes, our youth ministries, like the World of Akiba Land. As well, we must push back on the myths that say black men are absent as fathers, that black men don't value education, that black men aren't hardworking. And we must develop a compelling hand that lets those who dare terrorize us with lynching and other means, that your day of reckoning is coming. That if you keep messing with us, don't be shocked when you see those princes coming out of Egypt looking for you, and Ethiopia stretching forth her hands to put around your neck. When we do these things, sisters and brothers, when we do these things that our manhood and our dignity demand, our heads will automatically rise once again. Our spirits will be lifted. Our eyes will look towards the heavens. And like Marcus Garvey, we too shall see princes coming out of Egypt and Ethiopia stretching forth her hands unto God. So brothers and sisters, keep your head to the sky. and you will see princes not only coming out of Egypt, but also coming out of Third Ward, Texas, and Compton, California, and Chicago's East Side, and Belize, and the Caribbean, and Liberia, and Burkina Faso, and the D, and Atlanta's West End, and College Park. So keep your head to the sky. Reclaim your dignity, and reclaim our people's manhood. And soon, you will say like Garvey, God Almighty is our leader, and Jesus Christ our standard bearer. We rely on them for that kind of leadership that will make us free. For it is the same God who inspired the psalmist to write, princes shall come out of Egypt, and Ethiopia shall stretch out her hands unto God. And at this moment, methinks I see Ethiopia stretching forth her hands unto God, and methinks I see the angel of God taking up the standard of the red, the black, and the green, and saying, men and women of the Negro race, men and women of Ethiopia, follow me. For methinks I see we are following 400 million strong. Methinks I see the ancestors marching with us. Methinks I see black boots marching and black fists raised. Methinks I will be with you forever in the whirlwind and the storm. Methinks I see heads raised and hearts inspired. Methinks the more we remember the suffering of our forefathers, the more we will fight on, even though the battle seems doubtful. Methinks I see sisters and brothers of all faiths and all affiliations coming together for the cause of black freedom, self-determination, and power. Methinks if you tell us to turn back, we will laugh you to scorn. Methinks I feel the love and righteous indignation of generations. Methinks I hear the rage of the powerless when they struggle to be free. Methinks I hear the black Messiah saying the kingdom of God is within you. Methinks I see black men standing tall. Methinks I see black women standing in their brilliance. Methinks I see black children growing blacker and prouder by the second. Methinks I see black people together, removing all labels and barriers, climbing the heights of liberty and ceasing not in well-doing until we have planted the banner of the red, the black, and the green on the hilltops of a free and redeemed Africa. Methinks I see our dignity restored. Methinks I see our manhood recovered. Methinks I see us having a power-filled Father's Day. And methinks we, me, you will keep your head to the sky.
to change the world.
Brothers and sisters, we come now to the time where we act upon our practice of self-determination, which sustains the many institutions of the Pan-African Orthodox Christian Church. The shrines of Detroit, Atlanta, Houston, our cultural centers, the Beulah Land Farms Incorporated, PAOCC Liberia, all were built upon the sacrificial giving that makes cooperative economics more than just an ideal, but a dream realized. Your financial support helps to keep our ministries in every region of the country relevant, transforming, and productive. As you donate today, make your tax-deductible donation by credit, debit, PayPal, direct deposit, or by check to the P.O. Box of your local region. Thank you for your sacrificial giving, which reflects the self-giving of our standard bearer, Jesus the Black Messiah. May God bless you for your tithing gift today, and we thank you for your continued support.
It's graduation season, church family. Please join us for worship service next Sunday, June 28th, for our National Graduation Sunday. We will be celebrating our members from Detroit, Atlanta, and Houston who have graduated from high school, college, or received advanced degrees. We'll be blessed with inspirational messages by Akiba Land alumni Bakari Alexander and Sheba Rogers. So join us next Sunday, June 28th, 11:30 a.m. Eastern Time, 10:30 a.m. Central Time.
Greetings. Welcome to our community news across the nation. Shrine 9 in Atlanta is hosting free COVID-19 testing June 26th and June 27th from 10 a.m. to 4 p.m. in the Shrine parking lot. This is a supervised, self-administered, shallow swab test. Drive through or walk up. Results provided within 2 to 5 days. Share this information with your friends and family. Let's get tested. The Shrine Cultural and Events Center of Shrine 10 in Houston continues to provide needed services. Our community food giveaway is held every Monday from 11 a.m. to 2 p.m., helping our people during these times. We will be closed Monday, June 29th and resume Tuesday, June 30th. Volunteers are welcomed and needed. Spread the word. Visit, like, and follow the Facebook pages and social media handles of the Shrine Cultural Centers and Shrines of the Black Madonna of the Pan-African Orthodox Christian Church. There you will find current events and info designed to empower us. Stay connected. If you're interested in doing your part in the liberation struggle of Black people, then join our movement. Send an email membership request to info@shrinesoftheblackmadonna.org. Thank you for your continued support. Have a blessed week and stay safe.
Thank you for joining us for today's stream. Join us next week where our service will be presented by Atlanta Shrine 9. Prayer of benediction. And now as we depart our virtual village, may the God of our ancestors, the Omnipotent One, who always keeps us connected, not only to one another, but also within the realm of divine providence, love and power, be with each of us as we go forth from this place to carry out the sacred mission given to us by the Black Messiah, Jesus, that we will lead us closer to a new and righteous kingdom of God on earth. Until we meet again, we say, Ashe and Amen.
Thank you. For every baseball event you attended, for every football game you hollered at, for every basketball team you coached, we say thank you. For every hair bow you clumsily wrapped around a ponytail, for every diaper you perfectly changed, for every imaginary monster under the bed that you chased away, we say thank you. For putting the toilet seat down, opening car doors in the rain, and patiently waiting on the bench in the mall when you didn't have to, we say thank you. for every late night homework checking, butt spanking, tear wiping, muscles aching, back breaking, food on the table making, in spite of what they say you are, we say thank you. Thank you for being the best you that you knew how to be in every moment. For loving our mothers in your perfection and imperfection. For loving our daughters and our sons in your wisdom and in your folly. For being our heroes, though your cape was torn. For being our protectors, though your shield was bent. For being our lovers, though your heart was broken, covered, and hidden behind a blinking sign that read, "In need of repair." Most of all, thank you for being pillars of faith that uplift, models of phoenixes that rise, and echoes of triumphs that exist to remind us of what we are. First, good, powerful, best, Black. Thank you. Happy Father's Day.
And for liberation, Black.